Okay, Shalom, Shalom. Kwam Yasala, Koholoyim La Yehovah Bashim Yahushai, Bahashim, Rakahakadash, double honors to our apostles and elders of Great Millstone who rule well, that by the Spirit taught us this beautiful truth. Just want to say the water to the Aki Manakwa, that's out here sincerely, keeping the law, statutes, and commandments of Yehovah Bashim Yahushai to the best of their ability. Jachanan Noah, just coming at you with another quick lesson. Pray that it's edifying by the Spirit. And of course, the true name of the Father, or basically what I said in the greeting, the true name of the Father, all praises, Kol Halal, all praises to the Father, the Most High, Yahweh, which is his real name, which means that he exists or he is to be, in the true name of his son, Bahashim, in the name, his son, Yahawashai. That's the true name of the Father and Son. Yahawashai means that he's the Savior or Deliverer in Paleo-Hebrew. In the Rakach Kadash, that is the Holy Spirit in the Paleo-Hebrew. So, you know, we do these lessons that let you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans know that you are the children of Israel. You are the true Hebrew Israelites, and that the Lord is making real moves on your behalf because he's coming back for the apple of his eye, the children of Israel, and the children of Israel only. So, just wanted to just touch on this particular lesson. I'm out getting a walk, so Salaki, you know, a little kind of pace walking, trying to get this little exercise in, so to speak, and a little breath. Yeah, so Salaki for the breathing. But now this video, I'm gonna play this video, but it's Kentucky Attorney General joins leaders from other states urging President Biden to classify fentanyl as a weapon of mass destruction. This is how bad this thing is out here, man. That they're about to try and change, or at least this is what this guy wants. And see, you Jake, you so-called blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, you out here dealing this shit, you out here selling this stuff. Hey, that so-called white man, hey, he gonna do you like he done in the crack days. And they gave Jake all kinds of time. It's Jake still sitting in jail from the 1990s off for crack charges, man. Because what's happening is Jake is selling this shit to these damn Edomites, these kids, the so-called white children. And they're dying off at a rapid rate. That fentanyl been kicking they ass. But we bring it out all the time that, you know, you so-called white people, see what's happening is you're reaping what you've sown. You sold crack in the neighborhoods of the so-called blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, especially the so-called blacks, the tribe of Judah. You know, you got Judah real good with it. And if that shit is starting to come back to bite you on the ass, man. But anyway, let's play this little video real quick.
And I'm Steve Hensley. First at 4, Attorney General Daniel Cameron has joined a coalition urging President Biden to classify fentanyl as a weapon of mass destruction. The move would require the Department of Homeland Security and the Drug Enforcement Agency to coordinate a response. Right now, it's classified as a narcotics control problem. Perry County Sheriff Joe Engel says they need more help in their fight against fentanyl.
Right now, it's the number one thing in our county and this region and, you know, across the nation and the state, the nation, that's causing most of the deaths when it's drug-related. It's fentanyl.
In 2020, fentanyl was found in more than 70% of overdose deaths in Kentucky. We'll have more on the problem tonight at 6.
Doing their ass dirty, man. You see? And you know who they're trying to protect. They're trying to protect their own people. See? When crack was on the scene, they wasn't thinking about you niggas. Now you can go to a vending machine and get, I think, what's it called? Narcan or whatever it is, you know, the overdose treatment that you can do on the spot for somebody. You know, hey, the so-called white man, they be having that on deck. They keep that shit in their pocket like an EpiPen. Like they're allergic to certain shit, man. Like straight up. So this is what's really going on out here, man. So you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, man, hey, y'all better step away from that witchcraft, man. Because last place you want to be is in a goddamn prison when the Lord comes, man. Or during Jacob's trouble. Or when these famines really hit. When shit really get bad out here. But let's just grab a quick scripture real quick. And this is pretty much what's going on with, you know, Esau, Edom, they're reaping what they've sown, and that's pretty much the deal, man. you can't get around it. Let's get that, because they've sown a lot of wickedness towards you, Jake, man. Whole lot of wickedness towards you, Jake, man. Then destroy Jake in these neighborhoods. Okay, well, let's get what we want. Let's get this Galatians 6 and 7 real quick. And it's a beautiful thing, too. These are the types of things that we pray for. We pray for the downfall of our enemy, man. You out here praying for God to bless America, you a damn fool, man. At least from the standpoint of you Israelites, you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, man. You should be rooting for this place to fall. Okay, this is Galatians 6 and 7. Be not deceived. Yahweh is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. And that's what's going on with this, these damn Edomites. See, they didn't give a shit about you, Jake, when Tyrone was fucking taking grandmama VCR and all the money out of her purse, taking the car, the damn TV, and all this shit is at the pawn shop. They didn't care nothing about Jake. They sent Jake ass to jail and called them criminals. But now, when it comes down to these so-called white people dying, you know, from this shit, it's a mental health problem. Now we need to come up with clinics. We need to, you know, treat them. But how did they treat you, Jake? By throwing y'all asses into a prison cell, man. And like I said again, there's a lot of our people still in those prisons. But I like to always get this Job 34 and 29 with that particular scripture, because it's not only talking about an individual, it's talking about these nationalities, these nations of people as well, because the Lord is in control of all things. He's in control of individuals, and he's in control of nations, and he's in control of every single individual within that nation. So let's get this Job 34 and 29. It says, when he giveth quietness, who then can make trouble? And when he hideth his face, who then can behold him? Whether it be done against a nation or against a man only. So the Lord, he deals with nations. He dealt with us as a nation. You so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, why you think we're in the position that we're in? Because of a disobedience and also prophecy as well. You know what I'm saying? So the Lord is... He's dealing with us as a nation. And he's dealing with you so-called white people as a nation. Now it's time for you to basically give up the ghost, man. Your time is up. All that wickedness that you pulled off throughout the earth for hundreds of years, that shit is done played its role, man. It's that boat done sailed, man. It's about over with for y'all. And the world is gonna see it too. And we're praying for it, we're rooting for it. Matter of fact, let's get this because you know full well the only reason why weapon of mass destruction. Hell, you so-called white people are the weapons of mass destruction. Where you think that shit is coming from? All the dope. You got people not only addicted to street drugs, but you got people addicted to drugs that supposedly come from your Walmarts, man. Or your Walgreens. I mean, Salakia. Hell, Walmart too. Hell, they even got a pharmacy. Damn, Target got a pharmacy. Your CVS's and all these different companies, people are overdosing off your shit on a day-to-day basis, and you got a street problem, and you got a public business problem, man. This shit is out of control. But anyway, let's get it. Ecclesiasticus 25 and 7. Wait, we pray for it on a day-to-day basis. But a lot of Jake getting caught up too. There's some Jake getting caught up. But see, they're not worried about you so-called blacks. If it was just you niggas dying, they wouldn't be worried about this. They wouldn't be trying to make this into a weapon of mass destruction. Get the hell out of here. This man is sitting on a goddamn nuke, man. Ready to push the button at all times, man. Nukes on submarines. Nukes on airplanes. Nukes on every damn thing. They are the weapon of mass destruction. Hell, he need to be posting their asses as a weapon of mass destruction, man. Ecclesiasticus 12, 25 and 7, also known as the Book of Sirach. And he reads, there be nine things which I have judged in my heart to be happy. And a tenth I will utter with my tongue, a man that have joy of his children, and he that liveth to see the fall of his enemies. And that's what we're witnessing. So you should be thankful right now. You see? You so-called Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you should be thankful to Yahweh Bashim Yahushua, throwing up all kinds of praises and to our Lord for destroying our enemies, man, because these people are not your friends. But you got our people, man, hey, they so damn naive and so damn stupid. They actually pray for America, man, to God bless America is what they say. The hell out of here, man. This place is terrible. It needs to be destroyed, and it's going to be destroyed. And the Lord is actually doing it, and we're actually seeing it before our very eyes, man, which is a beautiful thing. So, you know, I'm not going to keep this lesson long. I just wanted to just touch on this because, hey, and we're not ignorant of Satan's devices. Let me get that real quick. We're not ignorant of the fact that this guy, he's trying to save his own people. He's because they're dying off quicker than they're being born. The opioid problem to go along with all the other shit that's going on with them. Committing suicide. Motherfuckers don't know what to do. You see? Okay, 2 Corinthians 20:11. Lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices. See, we're not ignorant of the fact that he'll use something like this to throw you goddamn Jake in jail for the rest of your life, man, just for a piece of that shit, man. Just for a small smidgen of it. Same way that they done that goddamn crack rock. Done Jake all kinds of dirty, man, with that crack rock, man. I'm telling you, man, it's Jake done spent their entire youth into adulthood, grown-ass men, then been in these jails for decades, man, with no chance of getting out. They fuck around. They just gave one young Jake life in prison. I think I guess his little mix-up killed like 11 people, and they not having that, man. They're not about to have you Jake out here selling their people this dope that's gonna kill they children, man. The hell out of here. And see, this is something that Joe Biden, he might pass, but then again, you know what, he might not, because he wants them votes, man. That might go against who actually voted for his ass, man. You Jake, man, he might say, nope, that's gonna mess with my black vote. Well, who knows, man. But the thing of it is it's just the whole idea of this is what this attorney general is trying to do. And you notice where he said it. Well, and it's not just Kentucky, man. It's all these fucking states, man. All these cities, townships, boroughs. These so-called white people out here getting high as hell. And if you've never seen any of the videos of out in is that I want to say Philadelphia, Kensington, I think Kensington Avenue or whatever the fuck it is. All you see is so-called white women and men strung out, and they young too. Young, man. Young, destroyed though. And like I said again, hey, you had no mercy, you're gonna get no mercy, man. And that's what's coming to good old U.S. of A, man. And it's not just the U.S. These motherfuckers is getting high all over the globe. And you know who's in control of all that stuff? Esau Edom. You got the so-called white man to thank for that stuff, man. You got that man to thank for the drug problems, the violence, the gun violence, the domestic violence. You name it. If it's violent, you can blame that on that so-called white man every single time, man. Because he's the one that's running the earth. The scripture says that the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. If not, wherein, who is he? If this so-called white man is not the one that's in control of what's being imported, exported, what's on the trains, what's on the planes, what's on the boats, you know, what's being brought up, you know, over borders and county lines and all this other shit. Hey, that man is in control of that stuff, man. He can easily have a fucking truckload or a damn shipment container load of fentanyl brought into a place, city, state, and have the police officers actually guarding that shit. Military guarding it at that. So, you know, I just wanted to just touch on that, man. So all praises to Yahweh Shimmy, I was shy for this. You know, double honors to our apostles again. You know, that rule well. And hey, we're almost there, man. The Lord is tearing his kingdom down, and rightfully so, man. It's time. It's time this place go down, man. You know, we need out of here. We need out of here. If this so-called white man is in rulership another 10 years, nothing will survive. These people are ready to nuke the whole goddamn globe right now. They're in control of that stuff, man. So with that, Kwame Yashala.